Another molecule in the benzimidazole family for us to talk about is known as Trilabendazole, that has a molecular structure which looks like this and is often abbreviated as TCBZ. And it's primarily used in one main indication, which is for the treatment of fasciolysis or liver flukes. And it has one main primary mechanism of action, which is very similar to how the other benzimidazole molecules work, which is if we zoom in on a parasite, we'll see that they're composed of a lot of microtubules, which they need to support their structure as well as to move nutrients around their cells. But if we zoom in on those microtubules further, we see that they're composed of other subunits known as alpha and beta tubulin, which need to come together or polymerize in order to build those microtubules. But when trilabendazole is added, it's going to specifically bind to a location on beta tubulin, preventing it from interacting with alpha tubulin. Therefore, that polymerization doesn't occur, and therefore we can't produce microtubules. So with trilabendazole added, we see decreased amounts of microtubules being produced, but an increase in cell death, which can eventually lead to the death of the parasite. Now, a much more less known mechanism of action for trilabendazole is also known to interfere with cytochrome P40, which is an enzyme necessary for metabolism and energy production. And it's been shown to decrease its activity, leading to impaired metabolism and impaired energy production. So make sure to leave a comment below on the next molecule you want to see broken down, and stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin.